about movies, music, and celebrity gossip. The boys from One Direction get molded and waxed.
This is insane.
Then, Lady Gaga rocks a 24-karat wheelchair with a plan to walk down the aisle. Nicolas Cage, Ryan Reynolds, and Emma Stone tell us why they love being a Crood.
I wish I could be that strong. My build is much more frail.
Plus, find out why some of Taylor Swift's fans may never ever forgive her like ever. And Steve Carell, Jim Carrey, and Olivia Wilde talk about that.
But I now know how to make a dollar float, which might be useful.
Now that's entertainment. When we thought she might be retiring, Mariah Carey surprises us with Almost Home, the hit track from Disney's Oz, The Great and the Powerful. Hey guys, I'm Dina Butti, and in case you haven't noticed already, I'm a little lonely in the studio this week because my partner in gossip simply has to go to Miami because he just has to film a video with Wyclef Jean. Tough life he has, huh? Well, since we are talking music, it is official, we've been snubbed. Gangnam Style star Psy has confirmed he won't be coming to the UAE. Instead, Harlem Shake inventor Bauer will be popping into Dubai on the 28th of March. Now, if you want to shake it on stage with him, you can submit your own Harlem Shake dance video and see if you make the cut. For more details, log on to our Facebook page. Now, every time we feature this next band, we get bombarded with emails from the fans squealing they want more. So here's One Direction getting a little sticky for you. Fans of One Direction will soon be able to meet their idols, or at least their likenesses, as the British boy band are being created as wax figures for Madame Tussauds.
Pretty cool.
Sculptors of the Waxwork Museum chain are working closely with the stars Louis, Liam, Harry, Zayn, and Niall in a process that takes over 4 months and costs around 840,000 dirhams per figure. They're being readied for a touring attraction that kicks off at Madame Tussauds in London on the 18th of April this year before moving to New York and Sydney.
We actually first heard when we were at Madame Tussauds looking at all the figures, so it was even like, more like, wow, we're actually going to get one of these made, and they're so amazing as well. I mean, the quality of work that goes on over there is mad. So.
This is insane. Like, all the biggest, you know, stars around the world get these wax works made of them, and why are we five normal lads just like jokers getting these wax works made of us? One way or another.
All right, well, there you have it. If you want a picture with One Direction and to ensure their bodyguards won't get in the way, you know where to go. Now, moving in another direction, some people will simply do anything to keep looking young, even if that means literally covering themselves with their own blood. So you're probably thinking, who in the world would do that? And the answer is a star who would do just about anything to make headlines, Kim Kardashian. On the latest episode of Kourtney and Kim Take Miami, Kim Kardashian shocked audiences by undergoing a so-called vampire facelift. The procedure entails taking 2 teaspoons full of blood from a person's arm, adding some chemicals, and injecting it back into the face. And though it has not yet been proven, the facelift is believed to stimulate the body to produce more collagen and give the face a glowing lift. In the episode, the 32-year-old reality star is seen cringing in pain and disgust. And yet, that hasn't stopped women from all over the world, including those in the UAE, from giving it a go. In fact, local aesthetic surgeons claim the treatment has attracted many Gulf Arabs and expats to fork over the 4,000 dirham payment needed to go all twilight on their faces. And speaking of forking over cash to look good, Lady Gaga is rolling in gold, literally. Since her hip surgery in February and having to cancel her Born This Way ball tour, Lady Gaga has traded in her tour bus for a 24-karat gold-plated wheelchair. While Gaga recovers in her chariot, rumors are flying around that the Mother of Monsters is reportedly getting married this summer. While fans are frantically trying to figure out the what's, when's, and how's of the event, the biggest question is naturally, what will Lady Gaga be wearing? The star has been spotted wearing a wedding dress on numerous occasions in the past, but with her outrageous style, the one thing we can bet on is that the gown she wears on her actual big day will certainly outdo the rest. Now also making headlines this week is a man who would like to cause some injury himself, and to none other than to the Biebs. Justin's already had a rough couple of weeks showing up late to concerts, collapsing on stage, canceling a concert due to poor ticket sales, fighting with a paparazzi, and his hamster even dying. Well, we're sorry, Biebs, but it looks like things are about to get a whole lot worse. Disturbing new details have surfaced about the New Mexico convict who was recorded during a phone conversation last year, saying that he planned to kill Justin by castrating him. The convict has now written a letter to a television station describing new threats, including arranging for a hitman to place an explosive device intended to kill Bieber and his entire band. Although the man has now been moved into solitary confinement, authorities are continuing to take his threats very seriously and are taking all sorts of precautions to ensure Justin's safety. As for singing sensation Taylor Swift, things aren't going so smoothly either. In fact, the country star caused fan fury this week when hundreds of letters addressed to her were found discarded in a Nashville dumpster, many of which were unopened. Taylor's management insisted that this must have happened by accident and that with thousands of fan letters received each day, the unopened letters must have been misplaced and recycled along with the opened ones. Yes, definitely a little clumsy, but we'll just have to forgive Swift this week as she actually spent her weekend with a 10-year-old fan who has cancer, signing autographs and playing music for her. Coming up, Rangrezz with Jackky Baghnani tells us why he needs a reality check.
You can also end up thinking you're God's gift to mankind.
Then, Ryan Reynolds refuses to walk next or even talk about his new bride, Blake Lively. Plus, Priyanka Chopra name drops the king of Bollywood to get ahead of the game. We find out how. That's coming up next. Welcome back to That's Entertainment. We're moments away from giving you the lowdown on Bollywood. But first, a little shout out to JT fans. Timberlake's new album, The 2020 Experience, is just days away. But if you'd like a preview, you can actually stream the album on iTunes for free. Also days away, the premiere for the psychological thriller Side Effects. We've got tickets to give away to the screening as well as to go see Bow Wow live on the 22nd of March. Just make sure you log on to our Facebook page to get in on the action. But now it's time for our local Bollywood guru to fill us in on the buzz. Priyanka is back in the news again, not for a good reason. She has been filming with a younger film actor on one of her movies, and apparently when he wasn't getting the shot right, she's been name-dropping Shahrukh Khan's name all over the place. She apparently told the young actor, if you don't do your scene right, I'll have Shahrukh Khan come and fix you. He didn't take very kindly to that, and I don't think the industry itself is taking very kindly to Priyanka's sudden close friendship with Shahrukh and how she name-drops his name everywhere. What does Shahrukh Khan do? Does he respond in kind? Does he name drop Priyanka's name as well? Interestingly, he has been talking great things about his wife, Gauri Khan. He hasn't been saying anything about Gauri in a long, long time. But suddenly, out of the blue, Shahrukh has been telling everyone, including at a recent event, that Gauri has held his family together. He's so grateful for Gauri and how great she is. Priyanka, is the desperate name dropping a sign that you're getting insecure about your friendship with Shahrukh Khan? And what is Gauri doing right? Well, stay tuned to find out. Moving on, Priyanka Chopra's cousin, Pariniti Chopra, is following in her cousin's footsteps. She is apparently going to move in with her boyfriend, her alleged boyfriend, Manish Sharma. Now, Manish Sharma is the director of band Baja Bharat, the hit movie with Anushka Sharma and Ranveer Singh. Pariniti has denied that Manish and her are dating, and when asked this, has actually said that she wants to slap the next person who asks her this question. Rumor has it though that she has admitted to her close circle of friends that Manish and her are indeed an item. Well, Pariniti, do as your heart pleases.
Ranbir Singh always does as his heart pleases. He was recently filming Besharam in Chandigarh, and Katrina was filming her movie in Delhi, and like a good alleged boyfriend, he apparently drove down to Delhi just to have dinner with Katrina. Now, he's a master at keeping the girls in his life happy. While it seems like he's an attentive boyfriend with Katrina, people tell us in Bombay that he's actually been two-timing cat with this high society girl from Mumbai's upper echelons. Apparently, mother Neetu Singh, actually approves of this upper society girl and has actually been looking into Katrina's background. Where is she really from? Where is she from in London? What kind of family does she come from? Etc., etc. Ranbir is quite chill. He has a hot girl like Kat and a nice girl like this upper crust society girl who remains nameless. He's a winner through and through.
Continuing with B-Town, the star of Rangrezz, actor Jackky Baghnani, was in DXB recently, and he gave us some inside perspective on the realities of being a new actor, losing 60 kilos, and just how difficult it is to stay grounded.
So this story is about a guy who helps a friend's love story and what happens to his love story and his family because of that. That's what Rangrezz is. He's a colorful person, that's why Rangrezz. Happy-go-lucky person, fills color in people's lives, his friends' lives. His friends are everything for him. His family and friends are before himself. And, you know, he's just someone who does first and thinks later when it comes to his friends and family.
Jackky admitted that, like his character, he too would do anything for good friends and family, but confessed that it's his loved ones who help him keep sane.
There are times you can get carried away, you know, live in your own bubble world, you know, completely lose sense of reality. You can also end up thinking you're God's gift to mankind. And so I think your family and friends, you know, get you back to ground earth.
To help him prepare for Rangrezz, Jackky said he needed his fair share of support as his newest role took him out of his comfort zone.
Yeah, the world was different, mannerisms were different. Where this guy came from was nothing close to what I've experienced or seen or have friends of. So, you know, it was a complete, you know, tornado which took place in my head.
But perhaps what frazzles Jackky the most is people assuming he's got it easy, just because he's the son of Bollywood producer Vashu Baghnani.
Yes, I do get special treatments. If I'm 10 minutes late, I get fired. A lot of times because I'm the director in my company. So after we finish shoot and everyone goes and chills, I have to do a lot of production work because he's not around. He's busy with different bigger things. So that's how I get it easy. So I sleep much later. I get up much earlier than other people because I need to work out because I was working in the evening. And after working so hard, people think I've got it easy. So yeah, I think I get it too easy.
And speaking of hard work, the feisty actor wanted to make sure people understood just how difficult it was to lose 60 kilos in less than 2 years for his role in Kal Kisne Dekha.
So I want to say this on air is that I've been asked that, oh, you've lost 65 kilos and you work out so much and you maintain it and it's 8-pack and it must be so difficult, right? And my answer is, yeah, there are people who are trying to lose 2 kilos or 5 kilos for years and I've not been able to manage that. I've lost 65 kilos and I have an 8-pack now. So yeah, it must have been very difficult.
And finally, we couldn't let Jackky go without getting a bit of an inside scoop on what it was like to do a little Gangnam Style.
This song, I've worked really hard to make fun of myself, you know, which you'll see that in the song. And yeah, I just feel that if you can make fun of yourself and make people laugh at your expense, you just become bigger and more stronger as a personality.
Sonner, air, Open Gangnam Style.
Coming up, we had the red carpet for the premiere of The Croods with Emma Stone, Ryan Reynolds, and Nicolas Cage. Plus, Jim Carrey, Steve Carell, and Olivia Wilde get down and dirty in the incredible Burt Wonderstone. That's coming up next. Hey guys, we're back with more entertainment, starting with the 3D prehistoric comedy adventure The Croods, which is taking over the UAE cinemas this very weekend. The stars rocked up to the premiere this week, including Ryan Reynolds and his new bride, Blake Lively, who stirred up a bit of controversy by walking and talking on the red carpet separately. Newly married Ryan Reynolds walked the red carpet for the premiere of his animated film, The Croods, in Manhattan.
Meet the Croods. I call this a snapshot.
Oh, let's do it again. I think I blinked.
It was also the first time he appeared on a red carpet with his new bride, actress Blake Lively, since they married last September. However, the couple arrived in separate cars, and Reynolds walked the red carpet and did his interviews without his better half. In fact, if reporters even asked about Lively, he just walked away. Reynolds, however, was happy to talk about the character he voices in The Croods. Guy, a man that's slightly evolved beyond the caveman family of the Croods who he comes upon.
They're like a species that's just one step down on the evolutionary chain. And he's a little bit scared of them, but he, you know, they need him to survive. He actually is in love with the daughter, Eep, played by Emma Stone. So he draws them out of their cave, which is collapsing and will no longer be useful, and teaches them how to survive in this hostile world.
Emma Stone voices Eep, a young cave girl anxious to get out and explore the world. Stone says she loves that her character has some meat on her bones.
Yeah, Eep is incredibly strong, physically and in spirit. So she's stocky, and at one point she falls on Guy, and he says, "You're so heavy," and she says, "Thank you," because she's all muscle. And I wish I could be that strong. That my build is much more frail.
Eep's wanderlust is thwarted by her father, Grug, voiced by Nicolas Cage, who's afraid that anything will lead to their demise. Cage said the screening had special meaning to him and his wife, Alice Kim Cage, who was also on the red carpet.
I'm happy to be here today because my little one, my 7-year-old, is going to see the movie for the first time. And he's never actually seen or heard me in a movie before, so this is a big day for us.
Stone, meanwhile, summed up the message of the film as, you gotta take some risks in life.
I think the biggest message is about living and not just surviving, and following the light. It's right there. It's a pretty simple message of staying present and hoping for tomorrow.
I'm calling you fire.
Hi.
It likes me.
Hey, it's biting me.
Try hiding from it in the tall, dry grass.
And now from one comedy to another, it's time to get an inside scoop on the magic that took place behind the scenes of the incredible Burt Wonderstone with funny men Steve Carell and Jim Carrey alongside Hollywood hottie Olivia Wilde.
It's not magic.
It's natural for a dying leaf to be frightened by the autumn wind. Your skin makes me cry.
They've played dark before. Steve Carell in the art house dramedy Little Miss Sunshine and Jim Carrey in such dramas as The Truman Show and The Number 23. But we've never seen either get quite down and dirty in a comedy as they do in the incredible Burt Wonderstone. Carell has the title role of an old school magic superstar who has burned out and been through what seems like every groupie in Las Vegas. Wonderstone's career is threatened by an up and coming magician of the Criss Angel David Blaine danger stunt variety, the suicidal, narcissistic Steve Gray. Think Ace Ventura with a dangerously insatiable hunger for fame.
I could never be the type of person that thinks, okay, this works, now I'm just gonna do this forever. You know, I'm always risking it and pushing it. And that's the only thing that keeps me alive and keeps me interested in this business. Because a lot of this business is stuff that you know, you have to put your lead shoes on and, you know, lift your feet and go in a direction. But the thrill of it is that ultimately you're doing something new.
Carrey and company literally wigged out over the roles, with bad hair days for just about everyone with a speaking part. According to co-star Olivia Wilde, Carrey wore a long blonde mane that just kept getting in his mouth.
You know, Jim had created a character and then saw the wig one day in the trailer, and he picked it up and put it on, and suddenly he changed the way he moved, he changed the way he spoke, he started using it in his rehearsing of the scene, and they said, let's use it. I mean, it brought out something entirely different in him. So I literally got to watch that metamorphosis. And with someone as incredibly talented as Jim, that's a real honor.
Carell and Carrie aren't the only ones who get to make magic in the movie. Co-star Olivia Wilde also shows off some impressive sleight of hand.
There's one trick that I did that's actually me levitating a dollar bill, which was a trick that I worked really hard at, and I spent many weeks on it, and they turned it into a butterfly in post, which I thought, well, I guess butterfly's probably more cinematic, but I now know how to make a dollar float, which might be useful one day. You never know.
I'm sure you've seen people walk on red hot coals, but I doubt you've seen anyone spend the night on red hot coals.
That was the newly engaged Olivia Wilde, who's just turned 29. A big happy birthday to her, as well as to Eva Longoria, Amir Khan, will.i.am, and Billy Crystal, who are all celebrating their very special day this week. It was also the birthday of the legendary Bollywood actor, and of course, one of the stars of the Oscar-winning Silver Linings Playbook, Anupam Kher. Now, first of all, happy 58th birthday. Wow. I got you a date cupcake, which I've tried to light, but because of the wind, it keeps turning off. So, considering you're an actor, you're still gonna have to pretend to blow it out.
Okay, thank you.
As you just saw, we met up with him to celebrate, and we'll be bringing you our very, very juicy interview with him next week. Now, before we go, a reminder that we've got concert and movie passes to give away, so head on over to our Facebook page for your chance to win. Now, I'm going to leave you with the trailer for Iron Man 3 and wish you a very happy weekend. Good night.
I'm Tony Stark. I build neat stuff. I got a great girl, and occasionally save the world. So why can't I sleep?
You elected me on a single platform. I will defend this country at all costs. The Mandarin must be stopped.
You don't know who I am. See me coming.
What are you going to do about these attacks?
The whole world's going to be watching.
The question, where is Tony Stark?
Things are different now. I have to protect the one thing that I can't live without.
That's you.
Mr. Stark. Today is the first day what's left of your life.
Go!
I'm gonna offer a choice.
Do you want an empty life or a meaningful death?
You're not a man. You're nothing more than a maniac.
I'm not afraid of you. No politics here.
Just good old-fashioned revenge.